First of all, my name is László Németh, and I'm the author of the Home Spell Checker and some LibreOffice, other LibreOffice components, for example, LibreLogo. It's a little extension, but it's, I think, quite interesting. And I last month I worked for a big Hungarian IT company, NISZ, as Gábor mentioned in his previous presentation. So I will speak about these developments, interoperability developments too. So, but yes, the first picture I didn't mention, but this is the Brussels airport with this interesting statue, and my second slide showed that this is a near 70 years old illustration from a famous Belgian cartoon, the Tintin, the Adventures of Tintin, and the text of this, maybe you can read it. So Tintin, the small person in the middle of the picture, show that he is the first man in the moon. And this is the revised version from 1969, and with a little humor. So the aim to show this picture is that the art can inspire, for example, children, but also LibreOffice development too. So one of the topic of my presentation, similar thing, I try to inspire or show inspiring thing in LibreOffice. So my agenda, first I will show and I will try to demonstrate the work of LibreLogo. All of my topics in this presentation were already well documented in my previous presentation in Tirana, the LibreOffice conference, and you can find these presentations. So I will try to demonstrate instead of showing more and more and more slides from my previous but similar presentations. So a new thing related to LibreLogo that in April will be published a new children workbook for German schools, and I mentioned in Tirana in October. I show some book covers, but this is a book series, and the new one, this one, now has got a cover, so you can check it. The author is Mirek Hansch, a German teacher, and his examples in this book is related to LibreOffice too, because LibreLogo is a little bit hidden component of LibreOffice. And the news about LibreLogo related to this German textbook and related to the research of the Florence University, where LibreLogo was used in the teacher education, IT teacher education, and kindergarten, nursery education too. So in October, I made several interesting improvements in LibreLogo, mostly fixes in the user interface, but I've added unit tests to the code, LibreOffice code, related to LibreLogo. So now in every full building of LibreOffice will check LibreLogo too. So it's quite useful if you want stable LibreLogo in LibreOffice. And on LibreLogo.org, it's a homepage of LibreLogo. You can read about the results of this unit test, interesting results of this unit testing. For example, Stefan Bergman, Red Hat developer, found a new regex change in Python 3.6 related to LibreLogo 2. Python 3.7, if I right remember. So I try to show something. Yes, this is in the picture. No, sorry, there is no something. I will try to set. Yes, this is LibreOffice Writer with a new page, and there is a toolbar here. This is a logo toolbar. You can found in the view toolbars menu. Yes, maybe I will show it. And you try first enable this toolbar. It's a little bit hidden because in this little machine it try to put in the first line so that you can find it if you are try it. And if you click on the run button in an empty document, you will get an example program, and if you, it's a real, it's an empty document. Yes, this was a not so empty, it seems. And I will try to enlarge these letters so you can see the English version of the LibreLogo commands. One of the interesting features of LibreLogo that it's very well localized. And in fact, all LibreLogo commands in the Putl server, the translation center of LibreOffice. So maybe if your language hasn't supported LibreLogo yet, you can try to translate the LibreLogo commands in a common interface or web page of LibreOffice. So, and run again, this little turtle pointer will draw a vector graphics. So one of the, yes, in this example, I will show that this is a real vector graphics, so you can modify in standard way of LibreOffice user interface after selecting the object. Yes, for example, here we can make new programs, or in fact we can use this input box in this menu. For example, forward will move the turtle. I will clean the image. Forward, for example, 200 points. This is a typographical point. So if you print your vector graphics drawn by LibreLogo, you will get correct measurements. You can, for example, use a millimeter or inch, 2 or centimeters, but it's a little bit too big for 200 centimeters. But if I right remember, the maximum of the page size of LibreOffice is 3 meters. So you can use 300 centimeters if you want. For example, 5 centimeters forward and right 18. I will center the turtle, and I may enter. Yes, it try to I will try to 100, for example, 100 right 100 degrees, and like a flower, like symbol, you can use automation, a loop, for example, repeat this command and fill the result. This is vector-based, so there is no, you don't need to center the turtle inside of a shape, because the shape is a real vector shape in LibreOffice. So fill command will fill the last object drawn by LibreLogo. So yes, this we get an interesting shape after, and I will modify a little bit or switch off this and select a better color, or in fact the default setting of the filling color is a little bit the 50-100 visibility transparency, sorry. So we can switch off this to no transparency, for example. We can choose a lighter color. As a normal shape in LibreOffice, double click on it result a cursor, so you can add the text to. It's sometimes is useful, for in the education or making new illustrations. In LibreLogo.org you will find, for example, Wikimedia Commons extensions or illustrations. Sorry, I will try to. Yes, it's correct. I will speak about spell checking too. So, sorry, my mistake. And I will try to show some more complex things too. For example, one of the fixes of the LibreLogo, it's fixing this magic wand. Pressing this magic wand for these shortening abbreviations of the commands, for example, FD, will transform to uppercase and not a full form, or not an abbreviation. And for example, a cycle, for cycle, maybe it will. Yes, there is a problem in the code. Let's repeat the correct command. Yes. Try to. So we get a triangle, and we can combine the different things. For example, a circle somewhere here, and yes, modify the field color, for example, maybe green. Pen color green, and pen size 13. This is the result. We can clear the screen with command 2 and using this home command, And if you try to modify the result, we got parts because the circle command will break the line. So if you want to generate a single shape, we can use the picture command of LibreLogo, abbreviation only pic, but I will yes, so there is an error, my int is line, and here too, yes. This, no, you can see this is a single shape because LibreLogo uses the grouping feature of shape handling of LibreOffice. So this is a interesting feature if you want to reuse the result of LibreLogo drawing. We can embed this picture, for example, right 6 degrees. We can use, for example, the degrees signed to. Maybe in the school it's a little bit useful. It can useful, and there is a new picture here, and a new repeat, and two, yes, and this is the atomium symbol of Russell's, and yes, this is a single shape, so you can use or you can insert a so-called GDI illustration. This is kind of vector format of LibreOffice. With this format, you can easily transform the result, or enlarge, or copy to draw, or etc. And I can show that with the ungroup command, you will ungroup this result, and you will get the six smaller grouped shape here. So sorry for that. Sorry for. But with undo, I can fix the symbol again. So if I'm afraid I have no too much time, so I will show other interesting things here. So okay. So other fixes here is there is a new parser. Instead of the heuristic method, now every complex logo expressions will be handled correctly. So it's also useful if you want to make more complex logo programs using different functions, for example, using Python functions. It's possible to combine Python and LibreLogo, and with this fix, it's more easier and more correctly. Unfortunately, I can't show you that there is a dragon curve example on the LibreLogo.org homepage. Using dragon curve, it's a recursive algorithm using two procedures, and before it is fixed, it wasn't possible to write the procedure names without parentheses. So it's also a useful thing if you want to teach fractals or recursion, etc. And the other topic, the language technology, if you have a German-like language, for example, not only German, but Dutch, for example, or agglutinative languages like Hungarian or Turkish. Now it's spell checking, it's much faster in LibreOffice because the new version of Hunspell spell checker has a multi-level time limitation, keeping the good suggestions, but instead of 5 seconds, for example, or more, now there is a maximum half a second or more or less time for the suggestions. So it's comfortable, more comfortable. So the new number text is a new library. If you check the numbertext.org, you will see the this tool. Maybe I'm afraid a little bit slow, so I can show you, but I will try in the last 5 minutes. So, and there is a new native number formatting format, this NetNum 11. With this, you can, and with the feature that the data files of this number text library originally used only for chapter numbering with number names, 1, 2, or first, second, etc. But with this simple text level disruption of the formatting functions, you can add very special extensions for numbering. The default functions is not only these ordinal and cardinal numbers in this library, but adding currency symbols or currency names. For example, the original of the history of the number text is a bug text function of the Microsoft Excel and OOXML standard. Bug text is a function to convert cardinal numbers, thank you very much, to Thai currencies, but and converting the Thai number names. So it's a very limited for an international standard. Number text has no such limitation. It can support much more languages. Recently, near 40 languages. So with NetNum, you can add special article, affixation, etc. Support to LibreOffice. So it's, I mentioned the extended slides, it's quite interesting, for example, Turkish or other languages, because, for example, in 2019 or 2018 have different affixes. For example, in 2019 or in 2018 in Hungarian, 2019 ban and 2018 was born. So there is a vowel harmony related variation. The news in LibreOffice, so about in the last 5 minutes about this development, we half a year we fixed near 60 bugs, interoperability bugs, and real without interoperability simple or plain LibreOffice bugs too. So instead of showing the summary, I will show a few fixes. And if I write, yes, and this is a daily build of LibreOffice. So, sorry, I will switch to the LibreOffice window if I can. And so, for example, one of the main topic of the last month developments is change tracking. So I will show a simple text here, and I will switch the change tracking, and here I will delete or remove text. And if I maybe I can show you in the old version of LibreOffice the similar thing. So I will switch here to yes and yes. And at the, not a big problem, but most of the our problems are small, but it's sometimes it's very hard to fix a small bug too. And you, if you click on the next change button, LibreOffice select the next change in the window, but the problem is you cannot add a comment on the change. Why? Because it's a bug of LibreOffice. If you click on the text, for example, you can add a new comment. Or if you select this from right to left, you can add a comment. But if you select with the mouse from left to right, you can add a comment in LibreOffice. But here is the new version, and in this version, this is a yes, you can add a comment, for example. Now, it's a useful fix, for example. And a bigger problem, and in fact, the solution is a better workaround, that in this old version, if you select a word and you made only a formatting change here, these changes, or bold letters, etc., in fact, that the problem I will show you, it's in you, which you will see, yes. If you select the formatting change, and instead of accepting to try to react, you cannot react to this change here, because it's related to the format. In fact, the next version of Open Document will handle this kind of problems correctly, but no, it's not possible. So you can react, and if you click on the React All, instead of reacting this formatting change, LibreOffice secretly will accept these changes. So it's a hard or serious thing, dangerous thing. For example, if you try to use LibreOffice among Microsoft Office or something things, but this is the new version of the daily version of LibreOffice, and if you try to do the same thing, yes?
Almost run out, the end of time now.
The next speaker gave me a few minutes, so.
Okay.
Sorry. Yeah, okay. So, only I tried to react all, but the new version doesn't remove this kind of only formatting change, but the button try to notice this, that this is a problem for LibreOffice. So instead of React, now there is a React Clear formatting, or React All Clear formatting button title. So if you try to react this, or clear, in fact, clear formatting, and click on this button, in this case, it was a real react of the change, because originally there was no any other formatting here. So we are working similar things, and maybe I will show more examples in the 5 minutes sections, if it's possible yet. Thank you, your attention.